What's going on, fellas? It's another C Boogie production. I want to salute you guys for subscribing to the channel. Also want to thank you guys for liking the videos. Shout out to the Dime Game Division. All right, let's get into this video, man. Yo, but really quick, shout out to my boy Collada, man. You know, Dime Game Division member. You know, he out there doing this thing, man. But he behind the scenes, and he keep a lot of this Dime Game Division shit together, man. And, you know, that's one of my advisors, to be honest. So shout out to him, man. He out there in Oregon with the twin Teslas. You know, riding clean, man. But shout out to Collada, man. But I oftentimes, in my videos, man, I talk about women wearing a mask around the guy. You know, and I talk about how vital it is to get that mask off a female, because the quicker you get that mask off of her, the quicker you can find out the reason she is in your company. And that's why I said it's vital. You know, now that many different methods on getting a female to take her mask off. You know, that's up to the individual. You know, my method is specified for me and my personality, man. And it's a skill set, really, man, that I've developed over the years, man. You know, made a lot of mistakes in the beginning, man, and got back on that horse and got better and better and better. You know, just over the years with this shit, to now I feel comfortable and, you know, telling guys over this device how I get a woman to take her mask off. Now, first and foremost, man, you gotta understand. Well, rewind. What is the mask, you know, and why would a female wear a mask around a guy? Well, first and foremost, man, well, we all know women are the weaker vessel, right? You know, and with that being said, they're not gonna out-muscle men. So women gotta be charming, man. They gotta be cunning, you know. They gotta be sneaky in some ways. You know, they gotta hold in secrets and shit like that. And this is how women were able to survive, you know, because they're not gonna out-muscle men. You know, but they found a way to stay alive all these years on Earth. You know, so first and foremost, man, it's really a safety mechanism that they have. You know, and also another reason why women wear a mask is they want to get what they can get out of a certain man. And they know that they can't be honest around this particular guy because, A, he could be really judgmental, you know, or just ultra critical of her past, you know, past mistakes or past traumas. Or the motherfucker could just have this pompous ass attitude that's just turning her off. But yet, it's still something that she wants out of this man. So yeah, they'll keep a mask on. You know, and a sure enough sign that a female has a mask on is this. Well, this is one sign, you know. If a female won't keep it a buck with you, but all of a sudden, either one, when she's drunk, or two, when she's mad at you. If all of a sudden, she's telling you all these things about yourself, all of this shit that she held in over the months or years, and all of a sudden it comes out, and one of those two times, yeah, dog, she's been wearing a mask. Straight up and down. Now, one of the steps I use to get a female's mask off is vigorous conversation, dog. You know, and really listening to a woman, listening to the details. All women have a past, you know. Now, it's different degrees to her past, but all women have a past. And if you go deep enough into that closet, there's always some unsavory things in that past. Now, my thing is this. You know, I want to create the no judgment zone, right? You know, so I'm just sitting there listening to what she's saying and how she's saying it. You know, and there are times where I may ask certain questions. But if a female is revealing certain things to me and she's opening herself up, you know, I'm listening to how she says it. Now, if she's saying it in a braggadocious kind of way where she's, you know, bragging and raving about certain things, then, you know, that's a sign. But if she's saying it in a regretful kind of way that she learned the lesson from her mistakes, and she's indicating to me that she wouldn't put herself in that position anymore, well, that's an indication too. You know, so these are just a few examples of the things that I'm looking for when I'm sitting down talking to this female, you know. And, you know, if I decide to ask her questions and shit, well, I'm asking the environment that she grew up in. You know, I'm asking about her family, you know, what kind of family she come from, you know. That type of shit tells me a lot. You know, what kind of homegirl she got, what they do for a living, are they married, are they single, whatever, man. It's the type of questions I'm asking them, man, and that's the type of shit that I'm really listening for. You dig? Because ultimately, dog, this woman has to feel comfortable. You know, it has to be a certain level of comfort, man. And along with that comfort comes the gifts, comes the French toast, you know, comes the submission and the cooperation, you know, where you come home from work and she's rubbing your feet and she's rubbing your head and, you know, she's conducting herself a certain way in public, man. All of that comes with you setting that no judgment zone so she can be comfortable. Now, when I'm talking to this female, you know, I'm looking for breaks in the conversation where I can give my input, you know, real talk. And at times it might seem like I'm chastising this female, you know, but I need to know that she learned her lesson from certain mistakes that she made in her youth. You know, so certain things, I'm a bang on it hard. Boom. You know, see how she take it. You know what I'm saying? See how she take it. But with that being said, I'm pretty good at reading women. I'm pretty good at reading people, period. So I know exactly how much pressure to apply to each individual female. You know, it's not all the same. Some women can take a lot of pressure. Some women can take a little bit. You know, so you really got to know how to read that woman. And that's a skill set that you just develop over time. You know, just being around different women, man. Different varieties of women. Women from all kind of backgrounds. From the 85 to the 92. You know. And that's just a skill set you develop. So moving on, you know, that's what I'm doing when I'm dealing with a female, man. I'm leaving my ego at home, you know. I'm not worried about fucking that female while I'm trying to get her mask off. I'm not leading with my dick or no crazy shit like that. Nah, man. You know, because I need to know why she's in my company. See, a lot of guys go wrong. They don't mind a female wearing a mask. And then next thing you know, they get torn out the frame because they didn't take the time to get to know these things or figure these things out. Next thing you know, these guys online crying and shit. Nah, dog, you got to take your time with this shit. It's a process every time. And no two females are the same. The method is the same, but the women aren't the same. So, you know, the minor details or even major details of this shit is going to change every time. But basically, dog, you know, you just putting a woman through a mean psyche valve. You dig? That's all you're doing. But if you are that guy, see, here's the benefits of getting a mask off. If you are that guy that can get the mask off of a woman, it doesn't matter who she's talking to. Don't even matter if she's fucking married, dog. You know, you are the guy that she's going to submit to. You are the guy that she's going to adore. Know, the guy that she want to be around, the guy that she's comfortable with. That's the role that you want to play. Next thing you know, you somewhere in the background playing puppet master and shit. But that's another story for another day, man. You know, but getting that shit off quickly as possible, man. That's the key to your success with women. You know, getting that mask off and keeping it off. You know, and look, I talk about the high ground in my videos. Always maintain the high ground. But I've even learned how to be vulnerable around certain women and still have the high ground. Look, man, I've had women tell me some shit right there where they looked in my eyes, man. You know, very surprising and shocking shit. And I had to sit there and take that shit with a straight motherfucking face, dog. You know, and I can tell certain conversations with me started to become very uncomfortable over time. You know, but I've decided to match her honesty and her openness with some honesty of my own, you know. So I may tell them a few things about my past, you know, just to make them a little bit more comfortable so they can see where I'm coming from and let them know that I can speak that language. You know, I know the environment you come from. I come from that same environment. Here's what I've been through. Here's how I overcame things. You know, here's the trauma and the residuals that happened to me. You know, boom, that's another way to get a female open. You know what I'm saying? Look, women, they recognize a guy when he has a mask on as well. You know, and that's another reason women might keep that mask on, because you got your mask on. I don't wear a mask around a female. This is what you get. You know, what you see is what you get. And it's just certain things in my life that I can't fake. You know, bottom line. So for instance, you know, because of certain things I've seen in the war overseas, I have really bad dreams at night, right? I can't fake that, obviously. You know, I'm sitting there asleep, and women tell me all the time, you know, you was, you know, swinging in your sleep, or talking in your sleep, or sweating in your sleep, or shaking, you know, and there were times where I had to sit there and talk to women about certain things that I've been through in that environment, how I overcame. You dig? And that in turn opened this female up to me more and more. You know, because by nature, women are nurturing, man. Obviously to the guys that they like, right? The guys that they're attracted to. You know, that's key to knowing that. But women are nurturing. So a lot of them want to nurse you through that. You know, so like I say, dog, it's certain things that I just can't fake, you know, and that's one of the things that I can't fake is when I'm asleep, but I'm having these nightmares and these night terrors, and I have them just about every night, dog. You know, I've woke up in cold sweats and my lady just sitting there holding me and shit. I'm like, damn, what the fuck? Or I've had some women said, you know, I jacked them up in my sleep, straight up had my fucking hands around their neck. You know, and they'd just be like, it's okay, I understand. You know, because I sat there and I was open with her, you know, about the damage that it caused me on the inside. You know, so they understand me a little bit more. You know what I'm saying? See how that worked? It's constant give and take, you know. But the ultimate mission is to get her mask off, man. You know, so sometimes you got to give a little bit to get a lot. No, nothing wrong with that. As long as you can maintain the high ground. You know, if I'm making any sense, man. Straight up. So if you are a guy and you don't know who you are, and you battling with these identity issues within yourself, then dog, her mask is never going to come off. You know, she just going to go along for the ride until she find the real thing. And that happens a lot. That's why that mirror that I talk about, that proper appraisal. You know, I'm never going to get off of that because it starts with yourself. You know, really taking that time to master yourself, knowing who you are. Man, women can sense that shit. Straight up, man. You're trying to be something that you're not. So the moment you figure out yourself, the moment you can deal with yourself and you master yourself, that's when you can get her mask off. That's when you get her cooperation. That's when you get her submission as a man. You know, a lot of guys don't know who they are. You know, and there's nothing wrong with that, as long as you're taking the proper steps to getting to know who you are. You know, now you're in the right direction, dog. Nothing wrong with that. The boogeyman not gonna judge you. You know, but if you don't know who you are, and if you are battling these identity issues, and if you're blaming the world for it, then I'm gonna look at you like you've really your doja status, man. I'm gonna look at you like you're crazy, dog. Straight up. Cause can you really call yourself a man if you're scared to stand in front of that mirror? I don't think you can. My personal opinion. You know, my personal opinion. You know. But like I was saying before though, all the benefits come after you get her mask off. You know, straight up and down. All the benefits come after you get her mask off. I'm talking about the real shit. Because you get a little bit when she got the mask on. But what are you really getting? You know what I mean? Some pity pussy? I mean, who wants that? Seriously. Who wants that? After you had the real deal, man, you're not going to go back to that regular degular. You know? I mean, you're not. And my thing is this. I got what it takes to kind of handle certain information given to me by women. That's why you're not going to catch me online, you know, ever talking negative about any of my exes. Now, I bring people up, but it's not in a negative way. I'm not going to get online and call my exes bitches and hoes and, you know, even the bad ones, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to do that. You know? I'm not going to get online and try to expose them. Nah, man. That's uncalled for. You know, because I've dealt with this woman. So was she a bitch or a hoe when I was dealing with her? You know, was she a succubus when my dick was inside of her? You know, she was mighty submissive when I was fucking her, right? Now all of a sudden she ain't submissive. You know, it's funny how that shit works. You dig? So I always keep that in mind, man. You know, that's just one thing you're not gonna catch the boogeyman doing. You know, I'll keep it real about some of my exes, man, but I'm not just gonna get online and kind of just, you know, undress them for the world to see and, you know, talk about them like they dogs. Nah, dog. You know, because I wouldn't want nobody to do that shit to me. Point blank, period. Period. So anyway, understanding what a female has been through, understanding the environment she was brought up in, you know, really embracing that, man. And that's going to allow you to really implant a lot of your teachings and values and a lot of your advice into this woman. You know, once you gain a greater understanding. And that takes leaving your ego at home. You know, you don't need your ego when you're doing this. You just need to be a stand-up dude. Only thing you need at your disposal. And know that this woman can trust you with certain information. You're not going to bring it up again when you're mad, even if she do it to you. See, my motto is this, dog. I don't give a fuck what a female is doing around me. I'm going to stand tall. You know? I can't have the same behavior as the fucking woman and still expect submission. That's not going to happen. You know? A lot of times, let me say this for a sidebar. A lot of times, females might buck at you just so you can dom them out. You know, I've been in situations like this plenty of times, dog. You know, women getting a little bit too mouthy and shit. And once I figured out what was going on, because I didn't react, I took my time. I thought about it. Pardon me. I thought about it. And my next course of action, I said, oh, you know, she want me to get live. So next thing you know, female getting a little bit too mouthy, grab her by the back of the neck, throw her in the bedroom, make her strip butt ass naked, boom, now I'm laying down my dime game. That's what she ultimately wanted. You know what I mean? So there are different reasons why a female might try to get live on a guy. You know what I'm saying? You know, so it's levels to that shit too, man. You just got to know the lady. You know what I'm saying? You got to know the temperature of the relationship. And you also got to know yourself, man. Straight up. But anyway, back to the video. You know, so to me, I think with practice upon practice at this shit, man, just dealing with different women, like I said, you know, you'll just develop this skill set over time. You know, you'll develop the shit and, you know, it should have become second nature to you, dog. It's like dribbling with your left hand. You know, you do that shit for a whole summer. Next time you get on that basketball court, boom, you hit them with the left and the right now. Now you unstoppable. You know, now you unstoppable. That's it, man. But everybody's process is going to be different. You know, some guys might come at that shit with a bulldog mentality. Some guys can come at that shit with more charm and finesse. You know, I think I come at it with a level of understanding, you know, a level of calmness and peace, you know, because I'm a Libra, dog. Everything gets thrown on the scales with me, you know. But it's going to be different for every guy. But one thing that's not going to change is the importance of getting her mask off. That's paramount, dog, to any woman. That's paramount. You gotta get it off. You know, you gotta get it off, man. I can't say that enough, dog. I can't say it enough, dog. You know, that's key to any kind of, you know, relationship or union with that woman. So always keep that in mind. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, your relationship with this female is not gonna be drama free after that. You know, still a female, still a woman. You know, she's still governed by her emotions. See, where a lot of guys go wrong is a lot of guys want women to think like men with a rational mind. But here's what I say to that. If women thought like men, we would still like them. You know, those same qualities that we don't like in women that comes from them being governed by their emotions and being more feelings based, because women feel the world, you know, they feel the environment, you know, is the same thing that makes them women. And the things that we like come from them same emotions. So that's where a lot of dudes go wrong. Women are never going to think like men. You know, they're never going to think like men. You know, they're never going to be as logical as men. You know, especially, you know, times where they get mad, or, you know, times where situations call for them to be emotional. Women have to be like this. You know, let me give you an example. Let's say a husband and wife was out in public and somebody tried to snatch that child. Now the man, he's going to look for the most efficient, quickest, and maybe safest way to get the child back. But the female was going to go buck wild crazy protecting her young. She don't give a fuck. She don't give a fuck if a bus is coming and she got to run in front of that bus and she's, you know, trying to dodge the bus on some Matrix shit. She don't even give a fuck. She's not even thinking like that at that time, dog. You see what I'm saying? In that moment, that woman has to be irrational, illogical at that moment, man. You dig what I'm saying? So there's a reason why women, you know, think the way they think. And there's a reason why men, we think the way we think. You know, that yin-yang balance, man. You know? And put together properly, that's a great union. You know? But one of the things we have is a lot of women trying to take man roles. And a lot of men don't even know the role of a fucking man. You know? And to stand tall. And to be that man, be that anchor no matter what's going on around him. Just because a female has did you wrong or said certain things to you or maybe fucked you over, to me, that's still not a license to be dishonorable. You know, one of the things I see is we have a lack of honor around this motherfucker. You know, I mean, because look, right or wrong, being right or wrong, you know, sometimes that can be subjective, especially according to the circumstances. You dig? But honor, that never changes. You know, doing the honorable thing. It's how I look at it, man. It is what it is. So, I'm not going to drag this video out. Like I say, man, to get her mask off, boom. It's going to be different for every guy. You know, every guy's going to have a different method depending on his personality, man. Depending on who he is and how he runs things, how he talks, his demeanor, you know, even down to how he look, you know, straight up, even down to how he look, you know. Oh, yeah. And let me say this before I bounce. Now, a lot of women, they're going to wear a mask around guys that are not used to getting women. You know, a lot of those guys, they are easy to manipulate. You know, if a guy been in the desert for 3 months, you know, he'll take any water bottle you give him because he's thirsty. Even if he's spitting his shit. And a lot of women recognize that. But women also know guys that have a level of experience with women. You know? And they know that mass is going to be harder and harder around that guy to keep it on. There's a difference in energy between those two guys. You know? The abundance mindset. Well, you got to have a real abundance of women around you. You can't fake that. You really got to have options. You know what I'm saying? You really got to be able to say, bitch, I'm going to leave you alone and I ain't looking back. Man, you got to die about that if those words come out your mouth. You know? A lot of guys say things to women that they don't mean. Then they go back on their word. Boom. The minute you go back on your word, she got you. Now you lost the high ground, dog. Can't do that. Can't do that. That's why it's vital to work on yourself as well. But I'm not even going to get into that. That's another video for another time. I'm going to stop this shit right here. Follow C Boogie on Twitter. You know, shout out to the Dime Game Division. Shout out to all my Patreon guys. All the guys that book consultations throughout the week. Greatly appreciate it, man. I love working with you cats. And a lot of guys just want to chop it up with the Boogie, man. You know, we just have fun. You know, it is an experience. But I want to say peace and also salute.
You feel me knocking?
I feel you.
Well, let me in.